Hey guys! So in today's installment, I'm going to show you how to paint your nails perfectly, every time. But first, you're going to want to start with a clean manicure. Then, now is a good time to pick your nail polish. So the first thing you actually want to do before polishing your nails is check the consistency. If your polish is too thick, you're going to want to grab your nail polish thinner, and you can add 3 to 4 drops to begin with. You can always add more, but you can't take away, so always start with less than you think you need. And then you are not going to shake the bottle, you're going to palm it like I am, but if your bottle is kind of oddly shaped, then you can just use the cap. So you just want to roll your polish between your fingers, and this is going to mix it properly without creating any air bubbles. This is very important because those air bubbles will transfer to your nail when polishing. Now we're going to grab our base coat, and instead of polishing my nails like this, the first thing you're going to do is flip it over, that's right, and you want to cap your free edge. The reason we're doing this first is because I'm going to tell you later. Then you can go ahead and apply it to your nail, and I like to go from side to side, so I don't distribute polish in the center first, and I'll explain that also later. Now, the second very important step, this is single-handedly one of the things that'll probably make the biggest difference in polishing your nails, is that when you remove your brush, you want to rub it against the neck of the bottle, and that's going to remove all of the color from one side of your brush. I know it's kind of difficult to see right here, but I'm not that smart. So, I'm going to show you it on another bottle. But doing this also fans out your brush so that you get a nice clean cuticle when you apply it to your nail. So again, we're going to flip our nail over, and you're going to cap your free edge first. And this is very important, guys, because doing this will increase the longevity of your manicure. This is where you do all of the wear and tear on your nails, so this is where the polish starts to retract first. Now to polish the nail, I drop a little bit of that excess polish off of my brush, and then I push it up against the cuticle line. And as you can see, because my brush is fanned out, it's giving me that nice smooth line without me really having to create it. And then I pull the brush down. This is how you create that really smooth, full coverage on your nail. You don't want to stay like a 16th of an inch or an 1/8 of an inch away, because as you can see right here, that doesn't look very nice. And it's not what professionals do. But if you have a hard time painting your nails in the midair, don't worry, you can just put your hand down on a stationary, I don't know, place. You can put it on a table, you can also put it on your leg, your knee, whatever works. And then as you can see here, I just do the same technique where I place my polish down, I push it up against the cuticle line to get a nice smooth contour, and then drag it down. And also guys, don't be afraid to take your time, go slow. Now you may remember that I mentioned some no-nos earlier. This is the reason why. When capping your nail after you've polished your nails, you can create a ledge. This is excess polish that basically is pulling and creating a weird contour on your nail. And also, any excess polish is going to get on your skin. It's going to get around the cuticle, and it's going to get on the lateral folds. Of course, not ideal, but I'll show you how to fix it if it happens to you. So from your manicure kit, grab your cuticle sticks and your cotton. I prefer to use these square ones just because it's easier. And then you're going to rip open your cotton pad, and you're going to just kind of roll some of that excess around it. If you guys know me, then you know how painful this is for me to do. I am touching this cotton and I am smoothing it over the cuticle stick. There you go, you've got a Q-tip. And in case someone is sitting there looking at their screen like, why can't I just buy Q-tips? Well, you can, but what I like about making my own is that you can control how much fluff is on your Q-tip. So even though you guys can't tell, I really don't have that much product. And I can really rely on the square shape that I started off with. So last is just to add your top coat, and I apply that in exactly the same method as the rest of my steps, and we're done. Now, if you guys haven't caught up with this series, you definitely want to check out the previous video so that you can get your kit and everything set up. So click right here to watch it. And if you feel like you already got this down, well then doing your own gel manicure is going to be really easy. I'm going to show you how to go from this to this. So make sure you subscribe so you don't miss that video. Bye guys!